third day of the Cornhill Test match at Edgbaston. Welcome to the highlights. And I'm afraid it was one of those Saturdays which happen all too frequently in cricket. A big paying customer group thronging the gates, trying to get in, eventually getting in, but no play because of rain. The Australians 294 for the loss of 6 wickets at the start. A misty day, light drizzle all the way through the morning, and not until 3 o'clock were the umpires able to get the covers off and the ground staff see the fruits of their labours. 294 for 6, and when we join play, it's the third ball of the first over, no runs have been added, and Fraser is the bowler to Dean Jones.
Certainly the pitch looks a little greener than it did at the start of the match. This morning there was quite a tinge of green, and since then it's had 4 hours under the covers, completely covered with tarpaulin, so we'll probably expect that the seam bowlers might get a little bit of movement off the pitch.
Well, beautifully bowled, and that's the type of leg cut railing Murph was talking about.
Yes, that was just about the perfect delivery. I suppose that the only thing it could have done would have been to clip the stumps. Certainly pitched on and moved out of the seam.
Angus Fraser is the bowler. Dean Jones, the batsman. ...102 to Dean Jones now, and one to Merv Hughes. Merv Hughes had a lot of trouble with Graham Dilley yesterday, fanning away outside off stump. Now he has to have a dash at Angus Fraser. Given him a long, hard look, but he'll have no difficulty in recognising him. He's the fellow who's 6'5½.
He was as perfected that shot.
Botham outside edge. Hughes caught Botham, bowled Dilley. Dilley strikes for the first time. That was travelling a bit. Nice sharp catch for Ian Botham.
Good delivery there by Dilley. Got that a bit straighter. Almost on off stump. The ball moving out a little bit. Turning Hughes round and going very quickly to Ian Botham. Knee high on his left leg there. Good sharp chance. Not many people are better catchers than Botham at slip. Got big hands and he doesn't miss too many.
Trevor Hones is the batsman facing Dilley. There's a bit of pace and movement there, a little bit of lift as well.
Yes, Dilley moved the previous ball into Trevor Hones, and that one going away and across him and bouncing. And fortunately, I'll get to the edge again.
Just a single down to Dilley. ...300 up. Just two men in catching position out there for Dean Jones. There were 3 slips when Merv Hughes was dismissed. Just Taparay and Botham now. And then the third man who was in the slip cordon has gone to a well, a sort of a backward point position, but for that square slash of Jones, he's really in a catching position. That's Graham Gooch. And now one of them has a chase. In fact, it's going to be Embury who will make ground from third man, but not quite quickly enough. Nicely controlled by Dean Jones.
Typical Australian stroke. Most Australians play this shot pretty well. Dean Jones, no exception. Beautifully timed in bisecting Gower and Gooch, square on the offside, and defeating Embry down at third man.
There's a good shot from Jones. Even though the outfield's had plenty of rain on it, it was still going for four. It was beautifully timed.
Well, again, this was the problem that Dilly's experiencing. As soon as he bowled into that leg and middle stumps, the ball doesn't swing. If it's slightly overpitched, and a player of Jones's class, he's very strong through that mid-wicket to square area, really times that away beautifully through mid-wicket.
It was good cricket. It was a very good shot and brilliantly fielded by Dilly.
Good shot by Jones, let the ball come on to him, kept his head really down, punched it away off the back foot. Dilly following through, it's easier to go that way and you follow through, just gets the left hand to it.
Russell couldn't get across to that. Embury can, and look at that running from Dean Jones. Three runs, might even be more. Well, some sloppy stuff there. A wild return from Embury. Russell couldn't gather it, and nobody even thought at the bowler's end. And suddenly what looked like twos turned into seven. That's a great shot. Might have been a bit in the air, but it was right off the middle of the bat. Holmes now starting to look a really well-organised batsman. Nearly got through, hurrying back on to the left-hander.
A quicker arm ball there, running in. Just getting the bat down in time there, Jones.
And the umpires have just conferred. A very gloomy scene. Australia gone on to 346 for seven. But to the joy of a large crowd who really have had short shrift today from the weather, the Australians have refused the offer of the light, and so play will continue. Paul Jarvis. On a useful delivery, coming right back on to Jones, managed to squeeze it out.
And Paul Jarvis looking to run in a bit steadier now and get a bit more control, and that was a good delivery. That certainly nipped back a long way. Would miss leg stump at the finish, but a very fine delivery.
Trevor Holmes, he's played his part in this partnership. Pretty tentative start, but he's settled down well now. Oh, didn't really move his feet. That could have been a wicket for Jarvis.
Yes, you do feel Jarvis just needs that wicket to give him that bit of encouragement. Certainly bowling more control now. He's coming to the wicket better, not charging in quite as quick. And quite a bit of life there. That really carried through to the keeper.
Oh, and another one, pitching and leaving, and that was a better ball. two good deliveries, but that second one was a beauty.
Yeah, that's probably as good an over as Paul Jarvis's ball this match. Roundabout on the length every ball, Bonnet left and right under batsman, going a good line to both of them. That will encourage him a little.
Jones plays Embiid pretty well. He likes to get down the wicket if he can, and if he can't, well, front pad all the way there and just the bat close alongside it. No gap at all. Down he comes. And beaten in the flight there. A good bit of bowling there from Embiid. It's a good battle between Embiid and Jones. Two high-class performers. See here, Jones, down he comes. Can't quite get there, but just making sure he's got it covered. And there's certainly some spin here for Embury. He suddenly clicked into gear at Lord's. He bowled well there, and the more he's bowled here, the better he's bowled. Oh, he's gone for the big hit. Fetched it from just outside off stump. Nobody out there, four runs. That's the 350 up, and Jones's 14th boundary.
I don't think with the Aussies staying on in bad light and playing a few shots like that, the captain has probably said, let's get on with it and have a chance of bowling at England. That was certainly the old-fashioned league slog, and well picked up by Jones.
That also brings up the 50 partnership. It was in the air quite a while after it looked to have taken it, saying that something happened that shouldn't have done, but the simple thing is it didn't stick.
Well, that's as straightforward a slip catch as you get. Waist high, straight in the middle. And again, Jarvis in lucky bowler. He's not had much luck in this series, and he has struggled a little bit, and the wicket would obviously do him the world of good, but the ball flying out there of Botham's grasp.
Well, and that's the inevitable thing. Poor Jarvis. Hadn't bowled all that well, but has enjoyed no luck whatsoever. And having had the wicket he was perfectly entitled to have expected, and seeing, well, still one of the best slip fielders in Test cricket, both, and put it down. This is what we see next ball, bang. Four runs. And that partnership now, a record one for this wicket at Edgbaston. Previous one was here 4 years ago between Lawson and McDermott. Well, says Jarvis, have a look at this one.
Jarvis gets quite a lot of pace without any real effort, and that was quite a useful bouncer.
Well, that's four runs.
He doesn't miss too many opportunities like that, Dean Jones. He has shown an ability to go on once he gets to the century mark. Already has two double centuries in Test cricket and a 184 not out to his credit.
That's fairly flown off the bat.
Beautiful deflection there by Trevor Hearns. And I think what the umpires are discussing is the batsman running down the pitch. Trevor Hearns was spoken to there by umpire Holder. once again, Paul Jarvis getting the ball to nip back on Dean Jones, and he gets the edge onto the pads down amongst his feet. When you're having a good trot, those roll back onto the stumps. I'm talking about the bowler having a good trot.
Very important for a bowler of this pace that he gets his rhythm right. It looks as though Jarvis has just about got that working today.
So he's bowled a couple of good bounces, one to Trevor Holmes that made him duck pretty smartly. On that occasion he made Dean Jones pull the head back. Or as we say in Australia, pull your head in, mate. He pulled it in pretty smartly.
It's four bowled again.
The light really does seem to have deteriorated in the last few minutes. But you must bear in mind that the Australians knocked back an offer of the light. So it's now got to deteriorate below that level that it was when the umpires offered it before they'll offer it again.
One of the reasons Russell is up over the stumps.
It's not a lot in it. Dean Jones actually makes a little movement just before the bowler delivers the ball. A little movement is with the back foot. That takes him very close to the line. But he just had enough grounded behind the line to be safe.
Yes, Russell's had a very good match, as indeed he's had throughout this series so far. Well, the next move from the Australian dressing room was to hustle a message out with the 12th man, Mike Valletta, to Dean Jones and Trevor Holmes to let them know that if the umpires offer them the light again, well, they should feel free to accept it. And that's exactly what they did after 12 more runs had been added. At 6.25, they were offered the light, and away they went at 3.91 for 7, with Jones on 141 and Trevor Holmes on 40. 97 runs added during the day for the loss of the one wicket. That's Merv Hughes, who fell to Dilley, caught by Botham, and he was out for two. So that's a splendid effort from the Australians and a good partnership between Jones and Holmes. The outstanding bowler again, I thought, for England was Angus Fraser. He'll be finding it a bit hard now to keep his concentration and to keep bowling as strongly as he has there, with 27 overs, 7 maidens and 2 for 50. So the Australians have done extremely well in this match to date. It's been, just a little tedious with the weather, I'm afraid. We can't do anything about it, but I'm just delighted that the Saturday crowd managed to get some cricket. There's nothing worse than coming to the ground, paying your money, and then not seeing a ball bowled. Well, at least they saw those 97 runs, and many of them made by Dean Jones, who not only has played well here, but also had a super test match at Headingley.